Hello students, in the previous class we have already discussed about the process of photosynthesis and we came to know that the leaf is the main site of the photosynthesis and we also know about the raw materials of the photosynthesis. So today we just concern about the factors that control the rate of photosynthesis and also the importance of the photosynthesis in the environment. So let's start it. So students, if we talk about the factors of the photosynthesis, then we can see that we can categorize the factors into two types. The first one is the external factor and next one is the internal factor. Now, internal factor means the structural part of the plants which are responsible for the photosynthesis are related to this. That means the number of leaf, size of the leaf, and the external factor, that means the atmospheric factors. So first one is the level of carbon dioxide, next one temperature, next sunlight, and next water molecule. So start with level of carbon dioxide. So all of you know that carbon dioxide is the main raw material of the photosynthesis. Now, if there is any deficiency of the carbon dioxide during the process of photosynthesis, then there will be no sufficient production of the glucose molecules. So, we have to supply the carbon dioxide as it required. So there is a maximum limit of the carbon dioxide to which if we increase the level of carbon dioxide, then the rate of photosynthesis is also increased. But after that, if we increase the level of carbon dioxide, the rate of photosynthesis will be decreased. So that means if the level of carbon dioxide cross the optimum level of heat, then it gives a harmful effect on the plant, which reduces the rate of photosynthesis. Okay, so the next factor is the temperature. So the optimum temperature for the photosynthesis is 20 to 35 degrees centigrade. Okay, to which the photosynthesis is occurred at its maximum rate. Now next, the sunlight. So here the plants, green plants or the chlorophyll molecules can absorb the sunlight within a wavelength which is 400 to about 700 nm wavelength. So in this range of the sunlight, the green plants can absorb the sunlight. Now below this or above this, the photosynthesis cannot be performed. Okay, now the next one is the water molecule. So water is also another important raw material of the photosynthesis. So if there is any deficiency of the water supply, then the photosynthesis rate will be decreased. And if we give it extra, then it also decrease the rate of photosynthesis. So we have to maintain its optimum level. Okay. So now the internal factors. So as you know, leaf is the main site of the photosynthesis. So any feature related to the leaf can hamper or can control or can affect the rate of photosynthesis. So first one is the number of leaf. Now with the increase of number of leaf, the rate of photosynthesis will be increased. So there is a direct proportional relationship. With the increase of leaf number, the rate of photosynthesis will be increased. And next, the size of the leaf and the presence of stomata. Now, broader leaf has more number of stomata and narrower one have the less one. So if the size of the leaf is bigger, then the rate of photosynthesis will be high. And if it reverses, then rate of the photosynthesis will be decreased. So in case of desert plant, as there is a crisis of water, they actually try to inhibit the release of the water molecules in form of vapor. Now water molecule is the byproduct of the photosynthesis. So for this, they actually modify their leaf structure. Now here for the cactus, their leaf is modified into the spine. Okay, now these are the leaf spines and their stem is modified into a broad fleshy greeny part which is known as phylloclade. Okay, so in case of desert plant, this type of or this special type of modification of the leaf can be found. Okay, so these are the factors that control the rate of photosynthesis. So now talk about the importance of the photosynthesis. Now for that, see the flowchart. Now it's a food chain. So here the green plant acts as the producer. As they are autotroph and they possess autotrophic nutrition, they can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis and thus they are known as producer. Now here grasshopper, frog, snake, hawk, all are consumer. Now they are directly or indirectly depend upon the producer one. How? Now the first one, the grasshopper, is directly consume the plant parts. So this is known as primary consumer. So primary consumer is actually such type of organisms that directly depend upon the producer or the green plants. Now the next one, frog. Frog consume the grasshopper. So this is known as the secondary consumer. Now the snake, this is the tertiary consumer as they consume the secondary one. And finally, the hawk, final consumer as it consume the tertiary one. Now see, producer produce the glucose molecule with the help of sunlight. So here, the light energy is converted into the chemical energy. Now when the grasshopper consume the green plants, this energy is transferred to the grasshopper. And when the grasshopper is consumed by the frog, then it also transmitted to the frog and then the next snake and then the hawk. So here energy is continuously flowed from the producer to the consumer. Okay, so if there is no photosynthesis, then there will be no flow of energy in the living organisms or in the food chain or the ecosystem. And the last one is a decomposer. What a decomposer? Now, when the green plants, grasshopper, frogs, snakes, hawk are dying, then these dead particles are again back to the nature with the help of decomposer. They actually digest the dead and decaying matter and release the energy into the nature or the ecosystem. So it's complete the cycle. So basically, photosynthesis is important for the flow of energy into the ecosystem. Okay, now the next one. Now see, during the photosynthesis, we get the oxygen molecule, and the main raw material of the photosynthesis is carbon dioxide. But what is the source of the carbon dioxide? Yes, the respiration. That means whenever we get any food material and we consume it, we digest it, and we produce the energy inside our body, then we produce the carbon dioxide molecule, which we release by the process of breathing. So the production of the carbon dioxide and the energy is known as the respiration, which takes place inside the cell, and we release the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere through the breathing. So after the releasing of the carbon dioxide, it get into the atmosphere. Now not only this is the source of carbon dioxide, there are many types of vehicles which release the carbon dioxide. Whenever we burn anything, it's release the carbon dioxide. So from all the sources, we get the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Now if the green plants cannot consume the carbon dioxide, then the level of the carbon dioxide inside the atmosphere or the environment is gradually increasing, which can break the equilibrium of the ecosystem. And for that, the green plants use the carbon dioxide as their raw material for the production of the glucose, and as a result, in return, they produce the oxygen molecule, which is again released into the atmosphere, and we consume it, or we use the oxygen molecules for the production of the energy. So it's a continuous process of production of the carbon dioxide and production of the oxygen, and use of oxygen and production of the carbon dioxide. So basically, if there is no photosynthesis, then the level or the balance of carbon dioxide and oxygen cannot be present or maintained. So photosynthesis is important for balancing the level of carbon dioxide and level of oxygen into the atmosphere. So this is all about the importance of photosynthesis. Thank you.